Recording.
Could I encourage you as you begin a new week? None of us consider ourselves counselors. In fact, we typically think those are the paid professionals. Those are the ones that have the certificates on their walls and the degrees behind their name. But every one of us is a counselor, each and every one of us. No matter our status in life, all of us have lips, and from those lips comes words. And those lips that bring forth words impart counsel, insight. So how do your words impact the lives around you? Whether family members or close friends, neighbors nearby, work associates, fellow students, God places people all around us who face struggles and challenges that oftentimes we can relate to, who need a word of encouragement and comfort, support, as well as direction and instruction, understanding. But before we share that tasty meal of truth on their table, could I challenge you to consider how you put that on their table, how you set the table? Because what we have to say is as important as how we say it. Don't write off your hearer too quickly. Be sincere, not artificial and distant. Don't be quick to judge without having heard their entire story. Remain humble in your approach, since you yourself could actually be that very person facing that struggle. Speak with sensitivity and sensibility. Be the eyes and the hands and the feet of Jesus as you speak words from God's word into their hearts. Counselees live all around us. So let's go and counsel. Let's follow the footsteps of the Savior who came and took upon himself flesh and blood, and who is called the Wonderful Counselor. As he walked in our footsteps, may we walk in the footsteps of those that we're seeking to counsel, those that we will share words with this week.